So hello everyone, welcome to this video. Today we are going to create this landing page. As you can see that this is a nice looking landing page here. We have a simple header here and also we have nice hero section. Also we have this section with some cards and also we have a CTA cards here and we have a nice footer here. So also this website is fully responsive. As you can see that if I come to the iPhone X. So in the iPhone X, it will look like that. Also, if I come to any kind of device, something like tablet, iPad, as you can see that this device is looking good. So I hope you guys will like this video and let's start this video actually. So here is I am in Frontend Mentor website and from here as you can see that that's the challenge that we are going to take for our landing page as you can see. So here as you can see that we have a download option which and here as you can see that we can download the all the starter file here. Just download it or what you can do is you can get the file from our GitHub repo. So come this repo also I will link it in the description so you can get the files from here also. And if you come to this page please give it a star. I think it deserves some stars. So once you have the files what you can do is let's open it. So let's extract all the files from here and open it with our Visual Studio Code or any kind of code editor. So let me use Visual Studio Code. And here it is. As you can see that we have all the design, something like for the desktop, it will be like that. Pretty good. Let me zoom in. And for the mobile, it will be like that. So you can see that it's fully responsive. Also, as you can see that we have an image folder where you can see all the images that we used in this web page. And also I have a HTML file and a style guide. So in the style guide, if you open the style guide, as you can see that we have some style guide, something like what color we need to use and also what font we need to use in heading or on other section. So also you can see that we have some resource for the icons because we are using some social icons I believe in the bottom. Yeah, that's the social icons that we need to use. So that's all what we need to do. So what we are going to do is we are going to use SAS for this web page. So let's create a file, actually folder called SAS. So in the SAS folder, let's get a file called style.css. So that's the CSS file. And for the CSS file, what we need to use, actually, we need to use a extension from Visual Studio Code, which is live SAS compiler. So that's the extension, as you can see that. So install this live SAS compiler and also come here in the settings. So I believe we need some settings for this live SAS compiler. So in the settings, as you can see that for this web page, we are going to use the settings for the live SAS compiler. If you want, you can follow me. So here what I'm saying that the save path will be in our current directory, means if I am in our standard CSS. And from here we need to go to back because I don't want my style.css file in this SAS file. So we need to get back or step out from this SAS file and create a CSS folder in this directory. So that's it for the SAS settings. And here let's watch our SAS. So once you have the live SAS compiler installed, you will get this in your Visual Studio Code, this button, and just click it. And as you can see that we already have this CSS folder, which is automatically created. And here we have no CSS for now, but in the future we will have some CSS. So it is working perfectly fine. So Let's come back to our HTML. So here, as you can see, that if I open the design so that we can get some style. So in the design, as you can see, that that's the design, and here we have a header section. This header section, we have a navbar here or something like that, and we have this hero section here. After that, we have some cards, and in the footer, before the footer, we have this also CTA card here. And in the footer, we have this nice footer. So that's a pretty simple layout that, as you can see. So let's come back to our HTML and create this layout. So for that, so let's have a, first of all, let's create a section. So section with the ID of, first one will be the header. So in this header, I will have another div with a class of container. So actually I will have this container div in each and every section, so it will be a common layout, something like section and container, and after that we will have our all the content. So after that, as you can see, that we have two part. First part is this navbar where we can see that the logo and this button. So and after that, as you can see, that we have our hero section where we can see our images and also the info. So first of all, let's create these in two parts. First one will be the navbar and second one will be the hero section. So we will have a div with a class of nav, and also we will have a class of hero. So as you can see, that in this container we have two div. First one is the nav and second one is the hero. So in the nav, what we will have is we will have a logo. So div with a class of logo, where we will have our logo. So let's create a img tag, and here we will have our images, and where is the logo. So this is the last one, logo.svg. so also for the alternative tag, let's create a logo alternative. So here, that's our for logo. So let's get another div in the navbar, so which will be our anchor tag. Actually that will be the button, so type will be the button. So let's have some class here. So if you can see that in our design, we have actually three button, almost same design on those three. So for that, what we can do actually, so for the button, we will have two class. One will be the common class for all the CTA button, and second one will be the individual class for the, this will be different for the each of button. So this first one will be the CTA header. So as you can see, we have CTA, which is common, which will be the common in our all of button, and this is the second class that will be different for the each and every CTA button. So that's for our navbar, and let's go to the hero section. So in this hero section, as you can see, we have two part. If I come here in this hero section, we have two part. First part is the info and second part is our image. So let's create two div. The first one will be the hero info, and the second one will be the hero image. So in the first one, what we will have actually, we will have a h1, so it will be something like, oh, I forgot to give the text for our button in the header, sorry, in the navbar. So let's give the button text, try it free. So for the header here, for the hero section header, what we will have actually, we will have this text, if you can see here. So that's the text, and paste it in the h1, and also we will have some paragraph. That's the paragraph. So I believe, yeah, that's the paragraph, and paste it in the paragraph, and that's it. And I think we also have this button here, so let's have this button. So we will create this button with the anchor tag, and also we will have type of button. So as I said, we will have two class. First one will be the CTA for common, and second one will be the CTA hero. So that's it. And for the button text, I will use get started for free. And that's it. So for the image, let's create an image tag and something like images, and the image that we want to use actually, that is this one. So if I save, that's the image. So that's all for our header section. So if I come here, as you can see, or it is. Yeah, so as you can see that's for all what we have. So as you can see, after that we have our card section here. So we have three cards actually. So let's style them. So let's create a section with the ID of something called cards. After that we will have a class of container. So in this container we will have our each of card item. So div with class of card item, and in the card item actually I will have two div. First one will be, if I open the design so that I can show, so two part. First one will be the image, second one will be the text. So here first one will be the card image. I believe first one will be the info. After that we will have the image one, and for the info let's create a h3. So for the h3 let's have the text and paste it here, and also let's create a paragraph. And the text will be, for the paragraph is this one, cut it and paste it here. That's it. So after that let's have our image. After that I believe, yeah, let's have the image. So for the first image, so img, that we need to use actually is this grow together. So that's an image, something like that. So that's all for our one card item. So let's have more. So for the second one, the text will be this one. And the paragraph will be this one. And the image that we need to use for the second one will be this one, which is, as you can see. After that the last card item, so copy the h3 text and paste it here, and for the paragraph paste it here. And for the image, let's have the image actually. So for the image, for the last one, this one will be the image, yeah. So that's it for what we have. So that's it for our card section. So after the card section, as you can see, we have another section, which is this CTF of card. So let's have another section with an ID of CTA section, CTA card. And in this card section what we will have is, we will have div with a class of container, and also we will have a div with the class of card. So after that, so in this card we will have our h2. For the h2 we will have something like ready to build your community, paste it. And also let's have our anchor tag, means the CTA button. So the type will be button, and also we will have a class CTA and CTA card. And for the button text, let's grab this text and paste it here. So that's it for our CTA card section. Yeah, as you can see. Also, as you can see that we have this nice footer here. So let's have this footer. So let's create another section. And we will have an ID of footer, and in this footer we'll have id of container, sorry, div of container, and also we will have two part. Actually, if I open the design, as you can see, we will have this footer content here, and also we'll have this copyright. So for that, as you can see, what I can do, actually I can create two div. First one will be the div footer info, and the second one is copyright or footer copyright. And in the footer info, if I open, so in the footer, as you can see that we have four column of content, as you can see. So let's create a div with a class of footer one, and we will have four of them. So this will be the two, this will be three, and this will be four. So for the first column, what we have is, as you can see, we have this logo and the text. So let's have UL li. So for the first one, we will have a logo, so div with a class of logo, and here we will have our image, and let's have the logo image, and also give it a logo alternative. So the second UL, sorry, second li will be our this icons, and also we have, as you can see, we have text here. So this is something like icon box. So for that, let's have a div with a class of content, sorry, contact, and here let's have our first div with the class of icon. And for the icon, I will get back to it later. So for the second one, we will have a paragraph, actually. So for the paragraph, what we need to use is this one for the address, actually. So that's it for our address. So let's have another li for our phone number. So let's have a div with a class of contact, and in this contact we will have first div for icon, as you can see. So that's the div, and for first div we have our icon, and in the second div we will have our content, which is the number of our phone number, as you can see. Get the text, paste it in the paragraph. So let's have our last li. So for the last li, we have this email. So we can say that for the, we will have a contact, and here we'll have first one is the icon, so div with the class of icon, and also we will have our this paragraph, which is this one. Actually, let's have the icon here. We do not need to have the div. Actually, we can use the image directly. So that's the image, and we will have the location for the address. Sorry, that's not the address. So this is the phone number. So for that, we will use phone number, and this is the address. So instead of this div icon, we will use also image here. So images, and we will have something location here. So that's an icon. So let's have the image for our icon. So that's it. Images, so we can use our this, what is the, it is an email. So that's it what we have here. So after that, let's go to the footer number two, where we will have UL and also the li. For the first li, we will have the about us. So that's pretty much simple, actually. And paste it two more time. For the second one, what we do, third one, actually those are the links. So for that, actually what we can do, create an anchor tag and paste it inside the anchor tag. So just cut it, create anchor tag, and paste it here. That's what we need to do. So the last one is, I believe it was FAQ. And FOTAR 3, ULLA. This one is pretty much same as our previous one. So let's get anchor tag and paste the text inside this anchor tag. Create two more as you can see, and for the second one it will be this blog, and for the last one we will have our contact us. So that's it what we have here. So after that, let's go to the, so for the footer 4 we will have some social icons as you can see here. So in the footer 4 we will have some social icons. So before that social icons, let's come here in our footer and create our this text of copyright. So just paste it inside a paragraph. So just open it and let's see how it is looking now. So open this with our live server. So this is the live server and this is the how our website is looking now. Pretty good. So also let's grab the social icons. So for the social icons, if I open my style.md file, so here as you can see that we have some resource for the social icon. So I will use this ionic icon. So just copy this URL and paste it here. So ionic icons. So here what you need to do for usage, if I come here, we need to add a script tag. So and here as you can see that we have this script tag, just copy this and paste it in our index.html. So before this body tag I will paste it here. So now we can use these ionic icons. So first icon that we need is we need to have this Facebook. Just copy this ionic icon tag here and paste it where you need to use it. So we need to use it in our footer 4. So paste it here. Not that, we need to paste the ionic icon tag. So this is for our Facebook. So also have the Twitter one. Copy the tag and paste it. And also the last one, which is for our Instagram. So copy this and paste it here. So that's it, as you can see what we have now. And if I open our website, we should see our icon here. So as you can see that the icon is here. So that's it for our HTML. So let's get back to our style section, which will be in our style.scss. So for the CSS, what we need to use first of all, if I come here, as you can see that for the web page we will use these fonts. So let's come to our fonts.google.com and here we can see we will have some fonts, and first one which is Poppins, grab this font. This one will be used in our headings and the weight will be only 600. So grab the 600 weight. Where it is, yeah, this one. And also let's have our Open Sans. So Google Fonts Open Sans, yeah, that's the font. And we need to use 4 and 700. So 4 and 700. So now let's come to our embed option, and here as you can see that we have an import, and copy the import tag from here and come to our style.scss and paste it here. So if I come to the style guide, as you can see that we need to use Poppins here. So what I can do, I can say that for the h1, h2 and h3 we will use our font family Poppins, and also we will have sans serif as a fallback. And for the other body section or body content, we will use our regular font family, which is Open Sans font family. will be the OpenSense. And let's have the fallback. And also, if you can see that in the style guide, we have something like font size of 80 pixel in the body. So let's have it in the body. So font size of 80 pixel. So that's it. After that, let's remove all the unexpected gap here. So let me do it here. And padding will be 0. And margin will be 0, and also box sizing will be the border box. So that's it. If I open, as you can see, it is working, not working. Okay, we need to add our link for the style sheet. So create a link style sheet. So link sheet here, whatever, I don't know, a style sheet. So it is in our actually CSS folder. So now, as you can see that we don't have our this unexpected style here, which is this padding or margin. So all the padding and margin is now 0. So after that, let's create some sass variable. So for that, what we will use. So as you can see that we have some colors here. So for the primary, we have this pink, and for the neutral, we have this three color here. So actually what we can do, actually we can use them as a variable. So copy them, just copy, not cut. So copy them and create some variable here. So let's add some variables. So in here, let's have this pink, and just what we need to do is we need to make it a variable. So we have a variable of pink. Also, let's have the neutral colors. So copy them and paste it here, and just make them as a variable. So also here, remove the gap, and we have a list of variables, as you can see here. So everything is perfect. We have our variable here, we have our h1, h2, h3, and we have our body. So let's style this now. So first one, we need to come here in the header. So in the header, the width will be the 100% and the height will be the 100%, or we can use auto, and also say that display will be block, and also give it a background image that we need to use in our here. So URL, we need to get back to our root URL, and after that we will go to the image, and we need to use the mobile version of the background, which is this one. So after that, let's have the background position. So background position will be the center top. And also we will have a background size of something like 120%, and also say that background repeat will be the no repeat. So also let's have a background here. So background, for the background color, what we will have, we will need to use berry pale cyan color, this one. So that's a variable, and the color is this one. So it is working fine, I believe. Oh, okay, we need to use the height is 100 BH actually. So it is not working because we did a silly mistake. So as you can see that that's now we have a background here, and also that's 100 BH. So working fine. So after that, what we need to use actually, we need to come to our container. So container. So in the container, we will have a height of auto, and also let's say that display will be flex, and align items will be center, and justify content will be center. So now as you can see, it is in center, but what I need to use actually, I need to make the justify content in the top, or what I can say start. And after that, let's have a text align in the center. And also, as you can see, that it is now text align center, display flex, and all other things. Actually, what I need to use actually here, this flex direction will be the column. So as you can see, that's looking perfect now. So also, as you can see, that these images, we have some images and this is quite big. So for that, what I need to use, so let's come here in the top and say that all the images will have a height of 100% and also will have a width of 100%. So now, as you can see, that our images is now 100%, something like that. So also in our container, we will have a max width of 1080 pixel, and also we will have something like, what we will have margin, so that it stay in the center. After that, let's also have some padding in 0 and 30 pixel. So what it will do, this max width, so no matter which large device you are on, this content will remain in this width, which is 1080 pixel. So that's it. So let's also make this style in common so that every container can have this. So in here, let's create a container and paste it here. So now, as you can see, that each and every section who have this container class now will remain in our 1080 pixel width. So that's looking good. So after that, let's have our nav bar. So in the nav, actually if I open, yeah, that's the nav. So in the nav, what we need to do, actually I need to make it position absolute. And also let's say that it will be in the top 0, means in the top side, width will be 100%. And also let's have some margin of 0 auto, so that we have some margin here. So actually, instead of this 100%, let's give it width of 1080 pixel max width. And margin 0 auto, so that it remains in the center. And also have some padding here, 30 pixel. That's it for our this nav. And also let's have some flex here, display flex, and align items, center, and justify content center. So if I give it display flex, as you can see that this one, which is our header, we can't see it because it is overlapping. So for now, let's just say that this position absolute in comment, so that we can style it. We will make it absolute later. So as you can see that this is the header, and for the display flags, what we have now, we have our logo and our this button side by side. So let's make it something like that, so that we can have some space here, as you can see. So for that, what we need to do actually in our nav, just say align items will be something like a space between. Not here, I think we need to make it in the justify content space between. So as you can see that space between is not working because we don't have a width here. So width of 100%. So let's see. So as you can see that now we have the space is between them. So after that, let's come to the logo. So it is in the nav. So logo, and let's say that width will be about 120 pixel, and for the logo. So after that, let's come to the CTA header. So as you can see that we are using link here for our CTA. So let's get an anchor tag style for common. So whenever I will use this anchor tag, this style will be applied. So this will be the common style, something like text decoration, that we don't want. So text decoration will be none, and also something like that, we want to make the color of the text is black. So something that we don't want, something like that, and also, and that's it, I don't need anything else. So as you can see that whenever I am using this anchor tag, means I am using also here, as you can see. So this is now applied here and there. So after that, come to the city header and let's give it some padding to our button in the header. So let's give it padding of 10 pixels top and bottom and 45 pixels left and right, and also let's give it a border radius because we want the rounded border radius, I believe. So come here, and as you can see that we want actually the rounded border, and also that you can see that it is a bold and the background is white. So let's also give the style here. So let's say that background that we want, background color white, and also let's say that we want the font weight to the 700, I believe. Yeah, 400. Let me see the style guide here. Yeah, 700 we have. So as you can see that it is now bold and the background is now something like. So after that, let's have a box shadow. So box shadow, not sizing, box shadow. Yeah, box shadow, I already tested out the box shadow. So let me just copy and paste the shadow value. So here, as you can see that we have subtle amount of box shadow here. So actually let's make it mobile size iPhone X, yeah, so that we can style it. So as you can see that it is in now iPhone and it is look like that. So also let's make the font size here. So font size will be 1 rem or 0.9 rem, yeah, something like that. So as you can see that this is not looking good in iPhone X because we have big space in the left and right. So this is happening because we commented out this position absolute so that we can style it. So actually let's also style this hero section. After that we will remove the comment from here. So let's come to the hero section. So it is in the container, as you can see. So inside this container, let's have our hero section. So dot hero, and here I will have a width of 100% and also height of 100%, so that we can have our content in the exactly in the middle. So after that, let's say that display will be flex and align items will be center, and justify content that we want is center. So looking good, but I need flex direction in the column. So flex direction in the column working fine. So that's it. After that, let's come to the hero info. So hero info, and here let's say that I want to style the h1, and let's say that font size that we want is 1.8 rem, and after that font weight will be 600 or 400, I believe. Yeah, that's the font. Okay, that's the Poppins font, which also have the 600. So after that, let's say that I want the margin bottom, which will be 1.3 rem. So as you can see that we have now much gap in the bottom. So after this h1, let's come, so after this h1, let's come to the break grab, and let's say that font size will be 1.1 rem, and font weight will be 400, and also margin bottom will be 50 pixel, and that's it. So after that, let's come to this CTA button. So as you can see that we already have a CTA class here. So this one have actually a CTA hero, something like that. So as you can see that we already styled our CTA button here. So what I need actually from our here, here is the style. Yeah, this is the CTA header. Just copy this style from here and come in the top and paste it as a CTA style so that we can have it in a common style. So everyone will have now this style, as you can see. So just I want to say that this background will be the pink, not pong, it should be pink, and also the color will be white, sorry, black or white for the pink. So as you can see, it is not working. So what is the problem? Okay, pink background color, pink is not, now it is working. I don't know what's happened, but so as you can see that now we have our pink here in the background and the white color. So what I need actually in our this CTA header, I just want to say that background will be the white and the color will be the black, and now it will be perfect for our header. So it is working fine. So also come here in our hero, so it is already styled, as you can see. I just want to make it bigger, so let's give it a padding. So padding will be 15 pixel and 50 pixel for the top and bottom, so it is now like slightly bigger. And also make the font size 1 rem, so looking good, not bad. So after that, let's go to the image. So it is here. So in the image, let's say that max width, so max width will be 500 pixel, and also margin top, let's give it a margin top about 80 pixel. So I want gap here. Yeah, looking good, not good, not bad. So margin top 100 pixel. Margin top is not working. Why it is not working? Okay, I need to apply this image style in the actual div, which is hero image. So let's come to the hero image. This was the hero info, and now we are in the hero image, and paste the img here. So as you can see that we have style here, but I don't want it t, but I don't want 100 pixel, I just need some 80 pixel. So as you can see, it is working perfectly. So the next thing that I want actually here in our container CTA, where it is, actually let's say that justify content will be the center. So now as you can see that everything is now centered, and just I want to make this navbar position absolute. So it is position absolute. Why everything is in the top? Okay, I need to make a width for the container. Okay, width will be, sorry, height will be not auto, sorry, not auto, it will be 100%. So now as you can see that it is now perfectly positioned, as you can see here. And as you can see, this image is not looking good. So for that, I need to come here. Where is the image? Hero image. And let's say that object fit contain. So now it is looking perfect. So also I think we should decrease the size of the margin, 60 pixel, 50. Let's decrease it in here. So it is in here, margin top. Yeah, this is the margin top. So let's keep it something like 40 pixel. Okay, so 40 pixel will look good. So perfect, as you can see, our this first section is looking perfect. So after that, let's come to the section of our cards. So this card section, as you can see, it is looking good. So let's create this card section. So come here and say that card or cards, which one? Cards actually. Okay, cards. And let's say that in the container I have a card item, card item. So for the card item, I will have padding something like 50 pixel, and also say that 30 pixel for the top and bottom. So we have our padding, and also let's say that we will have box shadow. So let's have the box shadow that we used before for the CTA and paste it here. So as you can see that the box shadow is looking not nice. So also let's have a margin of something like margin bottom 50 pixel. So the margin is okay, but the box shadow is not looking good. So let's also decrease it something like 1.13, and now it is looking fine. I think we have now more subtle background box shadow. Okay, after that let's have a border radius. Border radius will be 10 pixel and text align center. So now our text align is center and looking good. So after that, if you can see in our mobile, the image, which is this one, the image is in the top and the text in the bottom. We can do it easily by flex. So display flex, and flex direction will be column reverse. So now as you can see that our image is now in the top. So perfect. After that, what I need actually, I need to go to the card info. So in the card info, let's have a margin top here of 30 pixel. And after that, let's go to the H3. So font size that we want is actually 1.3 dem, and margin bottom will be 20 pixel. So as you can see, now we have a gap in the font after the font. So actually let's make it 1.5. 1.4 is look be good. Yeah, 1.4 or 1.3. So after that, let's go to the paragraph and say that font size will be 0.9 dem. After font size, let's come to the font weight and make it 400, and line height 1.5 dem. And the color that we want is actually our something grayish color. So let's call the variables, and as you can see that we have a variable of grayish blue. So this one will be the color for the paragraph. So that's it for our this paragraph and also for our card info. Let's come to the card image. Actually, do we need any style for the card image? So I don't think so, we need any style. So it is looking good for now. So after that, let's come to the card is looking good. Actually we need some space here. So let's come to the cards and make some padding here. Padding will be 100 pixel top and bottom. So looking fine as you can see. So after that, let's create this section, which is this one as you can see. So let's create this card. So this is actually the CTA card. So here CTA card, and say that display will be flex. So let's have some padding here, padding 50 pixel for the top and bottom. And after that, let's come to the container. Container. So after that, let's say that CTA card, and say that width will be 100%, and padding will be something like 30 pixel, and text align center, and box shadow. So we will use same box shadow that we used before. So let's grab this box shadow and paste it here. So now as you can see, we can't see. Why we can't see? So let's make it card, not city card. Yeah, now as you can see that we have our box shadow here. So after that, box shadow. Let's say that background will be the white color, and also make a border radius of something like 10 pixel. Yeah, looking fine. So after that, let's style the h2 here and say that font size will be 1.3 dem, and margin bottom will be 30 pixel. So now we have perfect text here. So after that, come to the footer. So this is the footer, as you can see. So come to the footer and let's have a background color of something. So we have this color, which is very dark cyan, and if I applied it, as you can see that we have very dark cyan here, and we have massive looking icons here, because the icons is, I think, having 100% weight. That's why it is looking so much big. So we will fix it. So color will be the white color for the text here. Yeah, the color is white, looking good. So after that, let's have a padding of something like 100 pixel and 0 pixel and 30 pixel and 0 pixel. So 100 pixel for the top, 0 pixel for the left, and 30 pixel for the bottom. We would want only 30 pixel for the bottom, because it is about, as you can see that in the bottom we don't need any kind of 100 pixel space, but in the top we need actually. So after that, let's come to the container, and the width will be something like 100 pixel, 100% actually, and display flex, and flex direction that we want is column. So as you can see, we don't have any much change here. So footer info, let's come to the footer info, and let's say that display will be flex, and flex direction will be the column. So now as you can see that it is in the column, this footer, if I remove it. So let me show you. So now as you can see that this flex footer content, we are having it in a row here, as you can see, but we want it in a column, because in the mobile design the footer will be in a column, as you can see. So after that, let's come to the justify content flex and start. So after that, let's come to our first footer, footer 1. So footer 1 that we want. So for the footer 1, margin top will be something like 30 pixel, and also for the UL, list style will be none, and also have the list. So in the list we will have margin top of 25 pixel. So as you can see that we don't have our list style, so looking good. So after that, let's grab. So after that, let's style our logo. So let's come to the logo. So after that, let's give it a width of 200 pixel. So it is looking good, but there is a problem. If I open the design, as you can see that the logo is white. Also in the desktop, the logo is white. So we don't have any white logo here in our images. If I open, we don't have any white logo. We have only the this logo .svg. So what we can do actually, let's open this SVG and copy the code from this SVG. Just copy this and close this logo.svg, and also create another SVG image here. So let's create a file here, not there. I want it here in this image folder. So let's name it logo white dot svg. So after that, let's paste the copy SVG code from the logo.svg here. So as you can see that this is the SVG code from our logo.svg, and here we have all the SVG code in one line. But I want to see it in a one time, not in something like that. So for that, what you need to do is you need to press Alt plus Z or Z, whatever you say. So just press Alt plus Z or Z. So this will make it something like that. Now you can see all the code of this SVG. And here, if you can see in this SVG, what we have two paths. For the first path, if I come in the top logo here, this is the same logo as you can see. So for the first path, which we have is for this icon. And for the second path, if I scroll down, this is the second path here, which is for this text. So we have only these two paths here, as you can see, we don't have any more. So what we need to do is, in this path, if I come here, as you can see, this is the opening path, and in this path we have this closing path here. So before this closing tag, we can say that we have a property which is saying that fill color. So we need to make it white for our white logo. So keep it white, something like 6F. And also for the second path, go to the closing tag here. Before the closing tag, we can see the fill color. So just make it white. So now we have our white logo. So let's apply it in our HTML. So let's come to the HTML here. Where is the HTML? Here is the HTML. So let's come to the HTML, and in the footer, let's apply our white logo instead of this only logo. So just hit enter and we should see our white logo here. So perfect. So after that, let's style this content here. So for that, we already gave it a style. So in the li, if I have any contact class, so if I open the HTML, you can see that we gave this style, sorry, in this class in our li. So however, we have this contact class under the li, so we will say that display will be flex, and also let's say that align items start, and also justify content start. So come here, as you can see that it is now perfectly in place. As you can see, the icon in the left side and the content in the right side. Perfect. So after that, let's come to the icon. So in the content, we also have an icon class. So in the icon, I will say that the width that we want is 15 pixel. So it is not working, because if I open here, as you can see that index, we don't have any icon div actually. What we have is actually we have our image img. So instead of this icon, what we can say the img. So now as you can see that we have our img, which is now having 50 pixel of width. Perfect. So after the image, let's go to the paragraph and say that font size will be 1.2 rem, and also say that margin left will be 20 pixel, flex 1. So looking good, as you can see that. So as you can see that we are having this problem. So in the image, let's have a margin top here of 10 pixel. This will fix it. Yeah, looking good, perfect for now. So after that, let's come to our this footer 2 and footer 3. So footer 2 and footer 3 will have also a similar style. So footer 2 and footer 3. So let's grab it together. And here what I need actually, I can say that UL list style will be none, and li margin top will be 18 pixel, and for the anchor tag I'll say that text decoration will be none, and color will be 1.2 rem. Sorry, not color, font size. And also I need the color white. Okay, good. Sorry, we need to grab the footer 2 and footer 3. So now it is looking good, as you can see here. So after that, let's grab the icons here. So social icons, it will be in the footer 4. Footer 4, and let's say that margin top that we want to have is 100 pixel, and text align is center, and font size will be 40 pixel. Yeah, looking better. Let's give it 80. Yeah, looking better now. So after that, let's come to our footer copyright. So for the footer copyright, as you can see, we need to apply it. So it is outside of our footer info. So come back here, and after the footer info, let's grab our footer copyright. So footer copyright, the margin top that we want to have is 20 pixel, and the text align will be center, and font size will be 0.8 rem. So looking good, as you can see, that's the website now we have. The last thing that we want is actually I want to overlap this section. So for that, what I need actually in our cart, I need to make a negative margin. So margin bottom minus 60 pixel already in place. Let's make it more 5 pixel, something 75. Something like 100 minus 100 pixel. So that's it. So 100 pixel is working now here. So after that, it is pretty much okay for our mobile design. So let's come to the responsiveness. So let's come to our desktop design. So whenever we will have something like that, let's design for our desktop. So we need to fix something here. So let's come here and say that create a media query, media only screen, and min width 768 pixel. And after that, let's come to our media query and let's have some style here. So the first thing that we want to remove is, if I come to our design, as you can see, so here, as you can see that this layout, so as you can see that the style for our desktop is something like in row. So we need to change the flex direction for our hero. So let's come to the header, and here let's come to the container, and in the hero say that flex direction will be the row. Now as you can see that we have row flex, but text align that we want is in the left, and I want to make this image bigger. So for that, what I need to do actually, inside the hero we have the hero image. I want to say that flex will be 3, and for the only hero info the flex will be 2. So now as you can see that our image is now big. So after that, let's also have some margin. So margin right 50 pixel, and also increase the h1, so font size 2.2 rem, looking good as you can see here. Also let's change the background. We have a separate background for the desktop. So in the header, let's say that background image that we want, so URL, so it is in the design. So as you can see, we have a background hero desktop SVG. So looking good as you can see that. Also let's say that background position will be center and background size will be cover. So looking fine. After that, we need to fix the cart section. So after the header, let's have our carts here, and in the container we will have our cart item. So here I want something like flex direction row. Now as you can see that everything is now flex direction row, as you can see. And also I want to have some padding here, 50 pixel and 100 pixel. So looking good. And I want something flex justify content center and align items center, yeah. And also say that I want it in the text align left. So looking good as you can see in these images and the cards. As you can see that if I open our images here, so for that here as you can see, so for the odd number of cards means 1 and 3, the image in the right side, but for the even number of card means 2, or if I have another card 4, the image in the right side. So what we can do actually, so if I have nth child, so if I have even, I want the flex direction column reverse. So now as you can see that, sorry, row reverse, not column reverse. Now as you can see that it is now reversed here, and I want the padding. So after that, let's have some space between our images and this text. So for that, let's go to the, what is the name, cart info, and margin left, let's give it something like 50 pixel. So we are having margin left for this even card, but for this odd card we should have our margin right. So in our regular card, let's go to the card info and let's come here and say that margin right will be 15 pixel. So now we have this as you can see. Also let's increase the h3. So here after the info we have also h3, and let's say that font size that we want 1.8 rem, yeah, looking better. 7, yeah, 7 is looking good. And also let's increase the font size for our paragraph. So the paragraph font size that we want is 1 rem, yeah, looking good. So after the paragraph font size, so we need to increase this card here, so CTA card. So let's grab the CTA card after these cards. So after these cards, come here and grab the CTA card. And here let's come to the container and grab the CTA card and say that padding that we want will have is 50 pixel. H2 will have something like font size of how many, 2 rem, and also have a margin bottom of 50 pixel. Not CTA card, I want to have on the card. So that's it. And for the CTA card or this anchor tag, so for the anchor tag, let's say that display will be inline block and also have some padding 20 pixel and 60 pixel and font size 1.2 rem. Yeah, it is now quite big as you can see. So for the footer, let's come to the footer. So after this CTA card, let's come to the footer. And in the footer, in the container footer info, I want to say that flex direction that we want to have is row. So now everything is now in one line. So after that, let's say that footer one and grab all the footer in. Here, so footer one, footer two, footer three and four. Three also have this. And the last footer four is will have flex one, and also say that margin that we want to have is 50 pixel for the left and right. So it is now looking good as you can see that here. Yeah. But I want to have much space for this one. So what I can say is I can say that footer one will have something like 1.6. Sorry, flex 1.6. So now as you can see that it is having much space. Sorry, it will be 50 pixel. So as you can see that, so let's say that we don't want margin something like that. Let's say that we only want margin in the left side, so 50 pixel. And for the one, first one, we don't want any margin. So as you can see that it is looking fine. And let's have it in the top. So let's say that for the 2, 3, 4. Footer 2, 3 and 4, I will say that top or margin top will be something like 70 pixel. Important. Yeah, perfect as you can see. I don't need this important, I think. Yeah, looking good, perfect as you can see. So the last thing that we want is actually we want to make this copyright in the right side. So we can do it easily. So in the content footer, after the footer info, we have also footer copyright. I want the text align in the right side. So that's it, it is in the right side. So perfect as you can see. I think we should increase the max width for this image. What do you say? Let's make it 700. Yeah, looking much better now. So as you can see that it is not looking in this kind of device, this kind of width of device. So let's also create another query selector for this kind of device, which will be something like 1000. So let's come here and let's create another one. So I'm creating it so that it looks nice in all kind of device. So only screen and min width 1000 pixel. So whenever I'm in this kind of device, so let's say that whenever I am in this kind of device, I don't want it in a row. I want it in our previous design, something like in a column. So to make it in a column, what I can do actually, I can grab this from here. So where I am saying that, not this one. So in our this query selector, where I am saying that this header, making this header in a row, so cut it from here and say that after whenever I will pass 1000 only, then make the header in a row. So now as you can see that it is in a column, perfectly looking fine. As you can see, column, column, column. But whenever I will pass 1000, now it is looking perfect. But whenever I am in this side, these all applied in already here, but this header will remain in row, sorry, in column, but all the style for our desktop design is already applied, as you can see. So that's pretty much looking amazing here. So that's it for the video. I hope you enjoyed the video, and if you did, please give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe my channel. And my name is Arfan. I will see you in the next video. Till then, bye bye, khuda hafiz.